Party, 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 after party.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Anybody who knows me knows that I love Africa, I love East Africa, I love Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, and meeting my brother here from Uganda today has been a really beautiful moment. It is VIP access. I'm always meeting VIP people, and I'm so thankful to finally meet DJ Cass, baby. How are you?
Awesome. I'm so happy to meet you. I've seen your emails, I've seen, like, you hooked me up with a lot of music. You know that, right?
I don't know.
Yeah, now you know.
Whoever is watching and doesn't know who DJ Cass Baby is, he's a big-ass DJ from Uganda. He's a Jameson DJ, and usually he's playing at the Alchemist in Uganda every Wednesdays, right? Seeing some really cool stuff from you. When you go to Alchemist in Kampala on Wednesday, you find a menu with something you can scan and has his mix. And I'm like, so dope. Tell me about that.
Oh, well, it's an experience. It's a vibe. Every Wednesday, it's called hashtag Jameson Hump Day, the Hump Day. So what we do is every Wednesday we record the mix that I play and supply it to everyone that knows that I'm going to be hooking guys up with everything, like the best music, because people know me in Kampala for playing the best music, like good quality stuff.
Hey, it's fine.
Shit. Okay.
As a DJ, what is your personality like? Because in person I tend to feel like you're a nice, shy guy. What type of DJ are you, and what should we expect in your show in Kenya?
I am that shy guy, but that's because I'm really shy when I'm sober. When I have the Jameson in me, though, that's when the real Cass Baby comes out. Like, it's a different persona, because it's a different vibe,
oh
you know?
God.
So it's just crazy, because I like to express myself in my music. I'm not these guys that hype up myself, like microphone and all that stuff. No, it's just with the music, I speak with my music. It's my first time to play in Kenya, actually, as a DJ.
Fantastic. So before we started this interview, we're talking about, we're comparing and contrasting the cities of Kampala and Nairobi in terms of the city life, club culture, and I was saying, I feel like one of the big differences between Kenya and Kampala is the fact that in Kampala, the ladies come out well-dressed, and you're like, no, that's not it. So what is it?
Nah, it's not the ladies. It's a mood. It's honestly a mood. You're going to come well-dressed, but still you're ready to turn up 100%. That's what Kampala is. Party, 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 after party.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
So for those who don't know the history behind Party After Party, the song,
actually, they know. One of the biggest songs right now is Party After Party by Big Trill. Shout out Big Trill, he's my guy. The biggest song in Kampala right now. It's doing well in Niger as well. Even in KE, it's doing well. Yeah.
But who's the first person who said Party After Party?
Oh, yeah, that's some political.
He wasn't a pastor?
Yes, he was.
So thank you so much, Cass Baby. Welcome to my city.
Nice
it's really
you,
great
Nico.
To meet you.
Nice meeting you.